mid-range handset business is heating up. Alcatel has made plenty of attempts to offer decent phones at excellent price tags, but more often than not it seems like there are better options out there. After recently reviewing the Idol 5s, for example, we found that you were better off going for the Lenovo Moto G5 S Plus or Huawei Honor 6X, both excellently reviewed phones, and top of their price range. Now, Alcatel is back again with the Alcatel Idol 5, which, unlike naming conventions suggest, was released after the Idol 5s, and brings a slightly different design along with a few new features all at the same $280 price tag. Better yet, it's on sale right now for as little as $150. Even at that price, though, there's some serious competition like the Lenovo Moto G5S, and the excellent Honor 7X. We put the Idol 5 to the test, to see if it can lure budget smartphone fans away from Motorola and Huawei. Good design with a few quirks. While flagship phones often place an emphasis on beautiful design, mid-range devices are generally more functional than beautiful. Thankfully, however, the Alcatel Idol 5 isn't a bad-looking device, though there are a few design quirks preventing perfection. The display comes in at 5.2 inches with a 1920x1080 pixel resolution, and in general use it looks pretty good. It's quite bright, which means it's legible, even in direct sunlight. It's sharp, too, so during day-to-day use you won't notice any pixelization, though we'll take a deeper look at that when we examine the phone's VR capabilities. The design of the Idol 5 is unique, and in this case that's not a bad thing. It's unique because of things like the metal frame, which curves over the top and bottom of the phone and houses components like the loud, clear dual front-facing speakers. It's the same overall look you'll find in the Idol 5s and the Idol 4s before it, and we like it. Unlike the Idol 5s, the phone is made largely from metal. That means that in a battle against the pavement the phone is likely to fare a little better than its glass-backed predecessor, though we did like that the glass back helped give the Idol 5s a little more sheen and prestige. Also on the back is a camera and flash, both in the top left-hand corner, and the Alcatel and Cricket wireless logos, along with two antenna lines that curve around the top and bottom of the phone, iPhone style. Buttons and ports are somewhat uniquely placed as well, and that presented a mixed bag of experiences. On the left of the phone is the power button, and the downside of it being placed there is that it's easy to accidentally hit the volume rocker with your thumb while you press the power button with your pointer. You'll also get Alcatel's programmable boom key, which was previously only found on the Idol 4s, and can be programmed depending on what you want to use it for. On the bottom is an off-center USB.